Hi, this is Lisa Lish at Lish Consulting. I'm doing a series on communication tips. Information on communication is the number one request that I get from clients, whether it's people in executive positions asking about themselves or their teams or specific employees, or employees themselves asking for information on how can I be a better communicator. That is my number one request. So I want to share some information with you because I know that there's a large need in the professional community for information on being a strong communicator. It really is one of the most important ways to be successful in a career and in a professional environment, is to be an effective verbal and written communicator. So that's why I'm doing this series on communication tips. And I also have some classes coming up, some online classes. So when those are ready, if you're so inclined, feel free to sign up for those classes to get even deeper knowledge on communication skills. Today I want to talk about listening, because listening is so important in having effective dialogue and effective communication. And to move a conversation forward and to really have influence, it is absolutely essential that individuals have effective listening skills, that they understand what the person who's talking is saying, and that they not only understand the words, but the meaning, the impact, and the emotion behind those words. So it's very important that we listen for all aspects of what is being said. What is the energy behind those words, but also the body language. It's important to take in what is the person's facial expression, how are they sitting, how are they moving, are they speaking confidently, what is their tone of voice. We want to listen for all aspects of the message to get the full impact of the message, and we really understand where the person is coming from and where they may have concerns about what they are sharing, or where they are particularly enthusiastic or motivated, and where they might be really focusing their energy. It's also important, maybe when we don't feel like we're getting a full message, to make sure that we're asking the right questions. And if we don't feel like we're getting the full message, we want to make sure that we are asking open-ended questions. Open-ended questions are questions that someone will not just answer with a yes or a no. We want to ask questions that get people to talk a little bit more about what it is that they're describing to us. We want to say, for example, how did you come to that conclusion? Can you tell me more about how you feel about that? What do you think will be the ultimate outcome, and what will be the impact of that? Try to get people to tell you a little bit more of their story, whether that is in the future or in the past. That's what an open-ended question does for you. It gives you more insight to what is happening, what has happened, or what they are planning, and also gives you more insight to the person, their motivations, and their values. And through that, you have the opportunity to get more insight to them personally and to build a relationship. So it's very important to listen, give people the opportunity to speak, and to be thorough, and when appropriate, to ask those open-ended questions to get people to even fill out more of the story. Thank you very much for listening today. This is Lisa Lish at Lish Consulting. A link to my blog is below. I invite you to subscribe to this channel for more information, and also to subscribe to my blog. Thank you, and have a great day.